Greetings, my minions, and welcome back to Attack of the B-Team Mod Pack with yours truly, Dr. Professor Double Frankosaurus Jr. Yes, indeed, that is a clipboard in my hands, and I'm not afraid to use it. Ka-chow! Told ya. What's on the docket today? Mad Science Today entails make example of Petra. Pterosaur! Right, that is short for pterosaur. And that's that winged dinosaur that causes so much aggravation. You know what? We're gonna skip that foolish bird prehistoric jerk. Make an HMS Reaper. Say that with me. I love how that rolls off the tongue. Ready? Reaper. HMS stands for Her Majesty's Ship. We talked about this, I think, in the last episode. We're gonna make a Flying Beagle airship. We were going to call it the Flying Beagle, you know, like Charles Darwin's ship that he sailed around the world collecting data about various creatures and so forth and so on, and wrote the Origin of Species. Yes, that beagle. Except ours is going to be an airship. It's going to be way better because Charles Darwin is dumb. And who left that door open? Everybody's up here having a soiree. Lovely afternoon here in the sun. Not a cloud in the sky. And somebody left the door open. All the flies are getting out. Listen, just because you guys are made of farm animals doesn't mean you're still living in a barn. Shut that door. Wait. You're not made of farm animals, but cats live in barns too. This is what happens when you make minions out of farm animals. They leave the doors open. You're not living in a barn, people. Huh. Lovely day. Like I said, not a cloud in the sky. Beautiful afternoon. Let's get started. And we have this project. Right, so I need to fly. Everybody fly with me. I have a bat. I killed a bat. So I appreciate the Pungence's wasp gift, but the bats are much smaller and faster, and they can fit in little tiny little holes. Okay, HMS Beagle, which we are dubbing HMS Reaper. I have all the materials. I have slaved for days, weeks, months, years. Okay, a few hours. And actually, several hours. It's been several days. I think the last episode we made was, what, last week? Egads. All right, let's grab all the supplies because I have a little idea in my brain, in my little bat brain, about a really cool build, this airship. Now, I have taken a cue from a schematic website. I just want to make sure I have everything. I don't have to come down all the way down here again for a while. And I'll put that in the description. The dude's name was Casper TFG, the Friendly Ghost, right? Is that TFG? Yes, Casper the Friendly Ghost. He made this lovely airship. Ow! And all I did was a Google on airship, Minecraft airships, and the whole bunches. I just want something simple and rather small, and I think his was the best, at least the most suited for what we want to do. Okay, I don't need the chisel right now. So shout out to him, although this is going to have many of my own designs and customizations, but I do want to just give him at least a little shout out. All right, so here's what we're going to do. We've got some floorboards here. This is just regular jungle wood that I chiseled up to make it look like long jungle planks. And we're going to do this, we're going to do five wide, and we're going to have the bow that way. We'll point out that way. We'll have the stern over here. That's the back, right? I don't know. I'm not a nautical person, but other than my kayaks, that's not really nautical. Well, I guess it is. I do go on the ocean with it. So we're going to do five out. One, two, three, four, five wide, okay? So we're standing here. We're sailing that way, and we're going to go 12 back. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. One, two, three, four, five. And I was going to fill it up. This is basically the decking. So these are nice floorboards that we have here. Jungly, jungly, jungly. There's lots of coffee this morning, Dr. Professor Dumble Frankosaurus Jr. How are you guys doing today? Good. Good. Wait. Wow! These go fast. Holy monkeys nuggets. All right, so that's the floor, right? So if this is going to be the front, well, let's sail her out this way so we don't smash into any palm trees. We're going to do three here. One here. Wow! I mean, what luck. Seriously, 64. That's cool. We're gonna use our mahogany logs today that we brought back from Tropicraft. I love this color. So beautiful. Unfortunately, you can't break these down into planks or anything. They just have to use the trunks. It's gonna look really nice. And I got some more ghost wood down in the nether. We never did our nether trip, did we? We'll have to do that. So, oh man, we're getting hungry already. We're gonna use our mahogany logs on the outside of this thing. So here's what we're gonna do. Just follow along here and just run them along the side. Dum-de-dum-de-dum-dum-dum. Like we place this on the edge, right, with the cut part facing forward and backward. And we're gonna put a little extra. And we're gonna cover all this up. And we're gonna get rid of this little fool that doesn't know which way is left or right or bow or stern or after port and pow and kazow, whatever they call that. Forward aft! Go to the forward aft! And then kick the stern in the poop deck. Something like that. So here we go. Look at that. All right, now let's get rid of this fool. We got two of these fools. I'll squat and grab you. Gaha! I win. Let's grab this guy. Wait, that's not you. You. Here you are. Here's the other crazy fool. I love building. No, I don't. Now, I did some of this off camera, actually, a few times just to get this part right. So that's why I'm buzzing along here because, man, I've been practicing. Once we get past the deck, it's pretty much hit or miss. Once we have to put a ceiling and a bottom on it. So it's gonna have a little hold up on the deck here, like a cabin, and then underneath a storage hold. And that's where things get tricky, but we're gonna do this. I might have to cut out and go refer back to what I've done off camera. Oh dear. That's all right, we're safe up here. We're safe. In fact, let's get some lighting on this. I wanna put a skull here. Bing. Got a bunch of skull lanterns. And I was gonna put some skulls in the back too. I think this guy. We're gonna do the fine tuning later, really, but I think this might provide a little bit of light. One in the back. I was gonna put one on the sides here too, but I'm not sure exactly where it's gonna go yet until we get the rest of this frame done. Alright. So yeah, I might either speed through this or cut out and cut back so I can go back and refer to some things. Alright, now we wanna count in seven from this guy right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the seventh one, we're gonna put that there. We're gonna count in right here. 1, 1, 1, 1. And I think what we're gonna do is come down here at the bottom too. We wanna go over 1, 2, and the fourth one. Yeah, I wanna be one in from the back. We do the same thing here. So these logs, I gotta cut this guy out. Yeah, cut off! And we're gonna put it back. So now it looks like these are going vertically, these are going horizontally. Just wanna keep the grain going in the same direction. Kinda sounds like I know what I'm talking about, almost. I mean, I'm no B00 or Corralis or all those other fantastic builders. But, But I play one on TV. Yeah, like that. And then finally, this guy here. Oops. Oh, dap-dee-dee-dip-dop. All right, this is A-shoe. And then A-shoe. I hope I have enough food for this project. All this flying around, make a bat hungry. Okay, let's get rid of the scaffolding. Because when we fly this thing, this is going to be a flying ship, by the way. This is going to be Archimedes' flying ship. Archimedes ship. So this is going to fly. The whole point of this is to take this guy and go exploring. Something that I really want to do on this server is explore. There are so many awesome biomes and things to find, and that's why we're even going through this exercise. And I could fly around as a bat, but that's dumb and boring, and you get hungry. And I want a ship because it's cool. I want to put skulls here. This is the cabin. And I want to make a workbench because I think I'm going to need a ghostwood door. I know I can make a ghostwood door. I was just looking that up. So let's just put you down temporarily here. Let me see. Yeah, see, it's in here somewhere. Yeah, there it is. Isn't that cool? Check it out. I love this ghostwood. This is necromancy and ghosty and things. So, fly. All right, let's open it up because I'm going to be coming in and out. Now we're going to use these double planks here. Ooh, a little lag there, a little sound lag. And I want it right between the mahogany logs, whether they like it or not. We're the boss here. Just remember, folks, when you do this stuff, you're the boss. You make the rules. Now, we want to put these here. One there. And I think one there. So this is our cabin. And we're going to be able to walk over here and look out. This is going to be sort of a balcony-ish, I think, when it's done. All right, ghost wood planks. That's these guys. So I wanted to work some ghost wood into this, too. And I think I'm going to like this theme and these colors together. At least in my practice run, it looked pretty cool. Now, I think what I want to do is just come across with these. Leave that open, because I'm going to put slabs across the top here. Mm-hmm. I like that. What do you guys think? Isn't that cool? We're not done. No, we're not done. We want to do a lot more. Let's put some of these in the front. Make sure we have enough headroom. Well, of course we have a lot of headroom as a bat, but you know what I mean. I don't really feel like switching. Let's get all this done, because I have done this, like I said, once off camera, at the very least one time, and I sort of have this down pat, at least this part. It's the lower part that's going to be kind of derpy. I'm going to go right to the end of the mahogany, I believe. Yes, we will. And then we want it to be above this mahogany as well. You know, let's not do that right now. So now what we're going to do is just fill in the roof. We're not going to go up much higher than this. All right. Let's just step back and take a peeky weeky. I like it. And I think I'm going to put See, we're going to have more skulls on the sides here, too. And I think it's going to be this guy. This is the one I want to remove and put a skull. Because we're going to have, again, this is going to be a balloon up on top. It's like a Zeppelin kind of thing, an airship, right? So we're going to have posts coming up here, and we're going to have the big balloon area up here so this thing can actually float. It's the only way to do it. So we want to make sure that our posts have some nice strong scully supports, because the posts, and here's the cool part that I didn't show you yet, is going to be made of bone. We're going to go right up through to the top, and I want to put one here too. I think put the skull, let's see, I was going to put bones here as kind of a fence, and I'm going to these in like that. We're going to do two. I'm going to double this one up. Yeah. All right. Let's take this one out and put a skull in here. Okay. I like it. I like it. I like it. I like it. And that there. And we're going to put these here as well, of course. I tried fencing and stuff. There is a ghost fence. There is a ghost wood fence. Yeah, there's the gate, but there is a fence, and I'm just not happy with the fence, the way the fence came out, and I kind of like the way the bone looks. This is just bone segment that we got down at the down in the nether. Kind of gives it more of a sinister look. So this, again, it's the Reaper. I'm sorry, did I say that right? I meant Reaper. Look at that creeper checking out Jenny's behind. Pervert. Okay, let's do this. Like it so far. Like it much. Like it much. Now, I want to go back over here and work on the back part. Let's just have a little flesh. It's cooked! Don't worry. And I want to do something here. We're going to come across the front like this. And should I do it here? Yeah, let's just do it from here. Let's come out to the front. We're going to go right to the last floor plank right there. And now what we want to do is come over here, here, and here. And oh, dear me. Oh, dear me. It's okay, because we're getting rid of a couple. I don't want this covered. I just want the supports there. I just want these above the support so we can get rid of these two fellas. This guy and that guy. Maybe I'll put those back. I don't know. And then what I want to do here is have a skull in front, because this is going to be another support up, up, and away, like this. So these supports are going to go straight up where the balloon is going to be. And I'm probably going to want, well, I'm going to have one here. Uh-oh. Okay, this calls for drastic measures. Which means use a full-size plank. Not drastic, I guess. Not terrible. But that ought to do. You know what we could do, and I'm really low on the ghost wood, is maybe put a strip down the middle. Oh, here's where the full guys come in play. Yeah, this is what we should do. Watch. Yep. Yep. Beat it. So let's do this. You know, get some of my slabs back, I guess, right? Let's see how that looks. We should go inside, too, just to make sure it's all flush on the inside. I like that. Okay, because the little extra depth, I guess. Okay. Very nice. Everything good here? And the bone, of course, the bone, these are going to go up. And I have a whole bunch of balloons that I made up for this. Which is really, they're pretty easy to make. It's just sheep, wool, and, well, of course you get wool from sheep, but it's just wool and string to make those air balloons. So here is the house, and yeah, the inside. I guess we don't need the full size here. Lots of headroom, and we got to do something with those corners, I think. All right, so let's just have a peeky. Step back and take a look. I wonder if we should put another post here. Like right through this dude's head. Oh, okay. Yeah, we will, but we gotta move this. Hello. Let's do that. Put the post straight up from the rear. Okay. Oh, is that all my posts? Oh boy. All right, I'm gonna need more posts because I think I wanna get this up higher. More bone segments. I guess we don't have to. I'm not sure how much room we need up top. So now we want to make a hold underneath. And this is where things get a little twicky. And we want to use... The one thing I'm avoiding is using any sort of carpenter's blocks or anything from Bibliocraft or anything of that nature. I don't want to use any blocks that aren't, you know, specifically Minecraft blocks. Hey, you guys didn't tell me about this one. Because I'm worried about that crashing the server. Because I think we've had some issues with that. Not me personally, but some guys have tried the carpenter blocks and things have crashed. So we're going to avoid that. I just want to use regular Minecraft blocks. We can chisel them and get different looks. That does work. I have tested that and it works out perfectly fine. But I'm not going to take any chances with some of the other stuff. You know what? No, let's bring that down. Let's bring that down instead. Dow! I said down. Nobody listens anymore. There we go. I very much like. All right, now the hard part, the hold. I think what I'm going to do is just cut out really quickly and go look at the hold I had built in my single player. Let me see. Where's the center? Roughly the center. But we're going to have a fence around. Let's just pop this guy out. And I want to... Oh, where's my ghostwood fence? Oh, good. Glad to hear it. I don't think these things will crash the server. The clear glass and panes. It's worth a try. So... Oh, I need to make a gate, too. Do we need a gate? Probably. You know, I'm thinking something like this. But I want to make sure I have enough room to walk out of my cabin. And then on this side, the port bow stern aftershock deck. And then we're going to need a hatch too. Let's make a quick hatch here. Okay, well, that was embarrassing. I made everything but a hatch. So we'll cut that part out. I don't need to see the face palms and make me sad. Okay, speaking of which, I wonder if I can make a trapdoor with other materials.
Oh,
Silverbell. Ghostwood trapdoor. Why didn't I think of that? Oh, dude. Okay, check it out. We can make a ghostwood trapdoor. Wow, that's awesome. Oh, yeah. That's great. So we'll put the ladder on this side. Okay. That was enough derping for once. Let me go gather some supplies, and I'm going to go take a quick review of my my ship off camera, the one that I built off camera, and we'll be back. I don't think I need... Well, you know what? Let's keep the ghostwood on me. All right, so stay tuned. I'll be right back. Okay, I think I'm ready. And while it's fresh in my head, let's get this done, because I think we're going to have to quit right after this part once we get the hold built up, because this video is now about... Oh, splash. About 25 minutes or so, and I think we're going to have to call it quit. So anyway, let's go down here about two blocks, and we're going to put in some of these floorboards. These are the same floorboards that we used upstairs. So let me just get my footing here, and we're going to put up the three... Actually, just two ladders here to get out. What? All right, make sure that works properly. Cool. So I think what we might have to do is finish the balloon end in the next episode. Or maybe I'll just do that off camera. But we might as well finish this up. So let's use the floorboards. We're going to go from this point. We're going to go five... We want five wide, so two on either side, and then I think nine back. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And we'll fill that in. Darn logs! Who's getting in the way? All right, this is going to look really nice. I have an idea. I played around off camera a little bit with the dispensers and some glass. So we are going to get our cannons in here. Now, let me just make sure we got some headroom. There's two blocks here. It's going to be tight, but it is a ship hold, and it's not meant to be comfortable. It's just meant to be functional. So it is what it is. All right, as long as we can move around down here. I don't want this thing to be, like, super bottom heavy. I have, like, a big old pot belly sticking out. So I'm trying to keep it down and somewhat slim if we can. All right, so we climbed down here, and now what we want to do is just fill in this wall. So the front wall, climb on down, and now we're going to use up some of our stairs. So let's see if I remember what I did, what I done did off camera. I think we did that. Yeah, we're getting there. We're getting there. I just cover up those floorboards from that side. Looks awesome. And now over here, let's grab our dispensers and our glass, because we're gonna have some shooting going on, right? All right, so now what we're gonna do is just take the stairs, there's extra stairs we have, and put them in the bottom here. Yeah, this is okay if this shows. I don't mind that showing. We'll do the same. Let's go right around. I want to make sure we get this right. I'm going to put the stairs right flush there. Okay. We'll do the same over here with the dispensers. We've got four. So we're going to have four cannons. We'll be rocking the cannons, baby. I hope. And then just a little jungle wood here, a little jungle wood there, and maybe a stair here, actually, or... half a slab. Okay, we're getting there. We're getting there. This is where the tweakage comes in. So over here, I think what we're going to do is... just give me a block. Put in some stairs here to get it a little more angle. And I think we're almost done here, peoples. This is why we don't build a whole lot with Paul. Every now and then you get a little derpy. It's okay. We'll get her done. No. No. I wanted you to do the whole turny-cornery thingy. Yeah, that one. The whole ternary cornery thingy. And let's make a few more stairs here. Oh my darn dog. So I'm thinking a little flare out up here, first of all, because this could use... Yeah, I'm definitely going to need more of this ghost wood, I think. Because I wanted one there. And I think I want to bring one down here too, like underneath as well. I think that benefits from a little bit of a flare out. What do you think? Square on both sides. Yeah, I think so. So if I... it's going to be close. And I'll probably do something with this back end. Like... You know, so my thought is to put, like, maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, like, all along the back here as well. I like that little flare out on the sides, too. So I'm just going to have to get some more of the ghost wood because I don't have enough. And I also wanted to make... maybe I will. Where's my fence? I had some ghost wood fence. Oh, darn. Come on, we're running short on time. This is... Whoosh. Hold on, people. Hold on. I wanted to just do that. Okay. All right. Yeah. And then let's get back over here. So there's two places. We can put the flare out higher or lower. I think I might like it lower. Like right here. And I'm going to need a little more. Dang you. Oh, so close. So close yet so far. All right. Well, that's a shame. Okay, so the last thing is then... Well, not the last thing, but the next thing will be to finish up that. I got to get a little more ghost wood, and we'll put the big floaty thing up on top so this thing can actually float. And our airship will be almost complete. Okay, I think with that, we're going to have to call it quits because it's about 30 minutes. We recorded the whole time and built the entire episode. There was no speeding through anything. Huh? Look at that. And there was no cutouts in building off camera. Now there is one thing I want to do over here, and I think I want to put some of these supports up. Like every... Yeah, those like that. I think that looks a little nicer. You. Yep. Yep. Yep! All right, tell me what you think in the comments, guys and gals, and if you enjoyed this episode, a thumbs up is always appreciated. Helps support my channel, shows me that you care, and that you guys are enjoying this, and I do appreciate that. And also, if you have any tips or comments about this particular build, if you see something that might make sense, you would think there's another tweak around here, something that you might want to see added, let me know. And give me some ideas about the balloon up top. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with that yet. I'm probably just going to stick them all around there, and then we're going to float the sucker away, and we'll go do our expedition with the Reaper. The HMS Reaper. I don't have to put a sign back here with the name of it, right? We'll do that in the next episode. Okay, gotta run. Hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you all. Let's just do this properly. And we'll see you all next time. Bye-bye.